Described and Captioned Media Program. In the classroom and online. DCMP.org.
Learning Zone Express presents Character Friendship Basics.
How do you start a new friendship?
Words on the blackboard. Friendships make a friend.
Well, scientists have shown that if you're going to start a new friendship, the best thing to do is to go up to someone. You're going to want to write this down and talk to them. You know, start a conversation.
He looks back at the blonde girl. She looks at the boy and curly-haired girl behind her. The girl laughs.
I don't know how.
Well, just because it's obvious doesn't make it easy. So here are a few tips that, with a little practice, will help you in those first conversations with someone.
On the blackboard, relax, everyone gets nervous.
Well, the first thing is, you need to keep in mind that everybody is nervous when they start that first conversation, including the other person. So if you say something that seems a little bit silly or weird to you, they're gonna be so happy that you're just talking to them, they're not even gonna notice.
On the board, talk about the other person.
The second thing, you need to talk about them. Everybody loves to talk about themselves. And the third thing is, talk about common interests. Are you in the same class together? Do you like the same movies? Do you like the same music? Talk about that stuff. Four, ask open-ended questions. That means that the answers to your questions are going to take more than just a one-word answer. It's going to need more than just a yes or a no. So, instead of asking, do you like badminton? Ask, why are you so into badminton? You see, if you ask a yes or no question, you'll get a one-word answer, yes or no. And then the conversation's over. So keep the conversation going by asking open-ended questions. And five, when someone's talking, don't just think about what you're going to say next the entire time they're talking. Just listen to what they're saying, and you'll think of what to say next, I promise.
The blonde girl sits expressionless. She picks up her books and stands in front of the other two students.
Hi, you guys are both on the swim team, right?
Yeah, it's my first year. I'm really excited.
Are you thinking about joining?
I'm thinking about it. I really want to.
The swim meet's next Thursday.
Yeah.
Do you guys like it?
Aha, the ice is broken. The first conversation is done. Whew. It's all downhill from here, right? Or is it? Now, taking the next step and talking to someone again is important. But relax, it's pretty easy. You can call them, or you can text them, or you can email them, or you can instant message them. You can even send a message by carrier pigeon.
Each one of these things is shoved near the girl's head.
Or you could just talk to them the next time you see them at school.
On the board, make a friend. One, relax. Two, talk about them. Three, common interests. Four, ask questions. Five, listen.
It's important not to rush things. Genuine friendships happen over time, so don't feel like you have to force something to happen.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approval list of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.